The left has maintained its strength in this European election, this in an adverse atmosphere, and that means that we are in a position to continue to defend the values for which we fought in the electoral campaign. This is social justice, this is the right to affordable, decent, climate-adequate housing, this is the right for decent and secure jobs, this is the right to have access to universally accessible public services, this is the right for a just transition to an ecological, sustainable economy, and this is the right of women for self-determination, for safe abortion, and last and certainly not least, this is the right for peace. We have, in a number of countries, remarkably good results. We are particularly happy about that after a period of absence, the left in Italy comes back to the political scenery. We are proud about the results we have in Scandinavia and Northern Europe, and we are very happy about the results in Belgium, and there are other examples of a good showing of our party. It seems to be that there exists an agreement between the forces of the Grand Coalition, the European People's Party, the Social Democrats, and Renew to continue their alliance, their cooperation. We acknowledge this fact, of course, but it would be a severe mistake to misunderstand the outcome of the election as a carte blanche for continuing business as usual and to go back to the failed politics of austerity. I say this because these failed politics have created the breeding ground for the rise of the far right in a number of countries. I mentioned France, and I am very unhappy about the fact that I also have to mention my home country, Austria, in which the FPÖ, which is a clearly neo-fascist party, managed to come out as the strongest party. As far as the left is concerned, we will be continue opposing in the European Parliament anti-social neoliberal politics. At the same time, I want to be very clear on that we are available for any sort of progressive forces, for any sort of progressive reforms and cooperation with progressive forces which may yield to progress for the working people, for social and ecological sustainability, and for social equality. And in this way, we will try to work inside the European Parliament, but as well outside the European Parliament. Thank you for your attention.